Says when Christ shall come with shouts of acclamation, take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. See, then I shall bow with humble adoration and proclaim how great thou art. So thing is, we're going to keep on singing this song even when Christ comes, even if we go and meet him one day. So what we're doing is, as I say, is just a warm-up or the worship. So can we sing like what we sing? What joy shall fill my heart? Can we sing with that joy again and sing the Tamil, English and the Tamil, and then jump in the party to the pie.
When Christ shall come,
says, he's still telling to the soul to bless the Lord. Sometimes physically we may not feel like worshipping God, or we come through some such situation, circumstances. But the psalmist says, why are you cast down, O my soul, bless the Lord. He's speaking to the soul to bless the Lord. So he's done a lot of things in our lives. So we can keep on thanking him. That's what the word says, to enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. So we'll sing the known song, Kodakudi Stotram. Here it is.
Yeah.
has done in the past. That's what we sang. Koda Kodi Sotra Meritum Kanakila Nanmegal Kathar Saida. But still, he's a God, nothing is too difficult for him. He's a God who did in the past, he's the same God who's going to do in our future. And the known song, Our Lord God, that was made the heavens, nothing is too difficult for him.
I believe in Jesus.
wonder if you believe that he is here, because once he resurrected, he came in the midst of disciples and said, "Peace be unto you." So it's a belief that he died and rose again. Can we all sing this song again? Incident, Satan came to God and he tempted 3 times. Right, finally, I think his intention is finally he wants Jesus, the English Bible says, to bow down and worship him. But I think in the Greek translation it says just a nod. He's expecting, I think Satan is not expecting Jesus to just bow down and worship. Tamil it says, Ashtanga Ulindu. Even if a devil comes and stands before you, I don't think you will fall down and worship him. So, what the devil is expecting from you is just a nod, okay. Whatever you say is right. And that's what he's expecting from Jesus with the original translation. The thing is, devil also wants him to worship him, right? It's not about only God that you're worshipping. People around us are worshipping anyway, something else, right? I just want to tell an incident. Hepsi's mom, it's a church, I think there's a new believer who got saved, and this lady used to have a snake pit back of his house, right? Like, she used to pour milk every day for the snake, and she got saved, and she no longer used to do that. And one day she was praying, suddenly the snake was coming and literally standing in front of her face, saying, "Oh, you are not bothering me anymore, right? You left me." Right? The lady closed eyes, it's a real incident, and she keep on praising, worshipping, and after some day snake left, and snake didn't come back again.
Amen.
Right? If you can see that the devil wants to worship him, right? That's what the world is doing. Anyway, so if you keep on worshipping God, I think whatever the devil plans, everything, God will defeat it.
Amen.
So let's sing the known song, "Oh Come Let Us Worship Him." Come let us worship and bow down, He's our God. calling us today, inviting us to come to the altar, and God's arms are open wide. He's a wonderful Savior.
Bye.
from He's true to His promises. Joel it says, I'll pour out my spirit upon all flesh. And lift our hands and say, Lord, pour out your spirit, Lord Jesus. He still came down, He's above all, but still He came down crucified for us.
the Lamb. You are holy, holy. I am Lord God Almighty. What is the Lamb? What is the Lamb?
Let your name be glorified tonight, Lord Jesus. Thank you for this time. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.